Welcome to another TechVid. In this two-part series, I'll discuss how to deploy high availability, or HA, on Sophos firewalls. In part one, I'll cover the different HA modes and prepare you for HA deployment. The detailed configuration steps are covered in the next part. This TechVid is linked in the description. Today, I'll explain Sophos firewall's core HA functionality and architecture, illustrating the packet flow in both modes, active-active and active-passive. Then, I'll further compare and contrast the HA modes, discuss failover triggers, and lastly, outline the prerequisites for preparing your firewalls for HA deployment. Let's examine a typical high availability network. Here, the Sophos firewalls are configured with mirror connections, providing continuous network protection and preventing a single point of failure. This allows for efficient, continuous access to crucial applications and services. Regardless of the mode, the primary device first processes all packets. This is because only the primary appliance responds to ARP requests by way of the virtual MAC address. As a reminder, the virtual MAC address is separate from the firewall's physical MAC address. It's assigned to and owned by the primary node, which is utilized by the HA cluster. The virtual MAC address responds to all ARP requests and is assigned to each interface except for the dedicated HA link. Let's return to the packet flow. As mentioned, the two modes that can be configured for high availability are active-active and active-passive. Active-passive HA pairs process all traffic on the primary node, only failing over to the passive node when the primary node fails. The auxiliary device participates in the cluster but does not process network traffic. It remains on standby until the primary device fails. If this occurs, the auxiliary becomes the primary device and continues to process all network traffic. However, in an active-active cluster, both devices process the network traffic. All requests go to the primary, which will load balance and forward traffic to the auxiliary device when needed. The primary device will process or forward the traffic based on whether the source IP address has an even number or odd number. For further information about load balancing, refer to the link documentation. And, as you'd expect, if the primary device fails, the auxiliary device will become the primary and process all traffic. Now, whether you deploy an active-active or active-passive HA configuration will depend on your specific needs. I'll quickly recap the differences between the two modes. In active-active HA pairs, both devices share the network load. All requests go to the primary device, which performs load balancing and forwards the traffic to the auxiliary for processing when needed. If the primary device fails, the auxiliary becomes the primary device and continues processing all network traffic. This provides your network with some resilience and increased throughput. In active-passive HA pairs, the primary appliance processes all traffic. The auxiliary is only triggered when the primary fails, giving you general network resilience. For active-active, there are other important caveats to note regarding load balancing. In this mode, the primary transfers connections to the auxiliary device, such as normal forwarded TCP traffic, NATed both SNAT and virtual host forwarded TCP traffic, and TCP traffic parsing proxy subsystems, such as a transparent proxy, direct proxy, parent proxy, and VLAN traffic. A common misconception is that all traffic is load balanced equally between firewalls. This is not the case. Moreover, an active-active HA cluster will not load balance the following data types or packets: VPN, UDP, ICMP, multicast or broadcast traffic. I'll now briefly discuss the events that can trigger failover. These include, but are not limited to, mirror port failure and device failure, which could be the result of power or power supply failure, or hardware or software failure. Refer to the link documentation for more information about the events that can trigger a failover condition. When planning your HA deployment, first ensure that the firewall environment is prepared with the necessary prerequisites. Refer to the link documentation for a comprehensive list. For now, I'll cover the most common errors network administrators make when configuring HA. First, for both devices, ensure you're using identical hardware. They should be the same model, with the same number of ports, and have identical firmware versions installed. We recommend you register both nodes in Sophos Central for easier management. Furthermore, you must use the same port for the dedicated HA link. If you set the primary device dedicated HA link as port 4, you must use port 4 on the auxiliary device as well. In addition, the dedicated HA link ports of both nodes must be configured in the DMZ zone with unique IP addresses, and these IPs must be within the same subnet. Lastly, SSH must be enabled and allowed on the DMZ zone. To do this, navigate to Administration, Device Access. Under the Admin Services section, check the box for SSH under the DMZ zone. Click Apply to save the changes. If you already use the default DMZ zone for other devices, you can create a new zone and select the type as DMZ. Go to Network, Zones. Click Add. Enter a name. Set the type to DMZ and enable SSH under Admin Services. Now go to the Interfaces tab. Choose the relevant port. Then set the network zone to the one you just created. Now, depending on which HA mode you deploy, there are a few additional prerequisites. For active-active, two separate licenses are required, one for the primary device and one for the auxiliary device. Furthermore, identical software subscriptions must be enabled on both devices. Note that this mode does not support DHCP or PPPoE. On the other hand, active-passive only requires one license, but this must be applied to the primary firewall, otherwise configuring high availability will not work. And this is the only mode that supports interfaces dynamically configured using DHCP or PPPoE. And as a final note, HA is not supported in wireless firewall models. And with all that covered, you're now ready to begin configuring high availability. The detailed steps are covered in the second part of this series, which is linked in the video description. I hope you found this useful. Links to relevant documentation can be found in the video description. For further assistance, view and post questions on community.surfos.com and go to techbits.surfos.com for more great videos like this one.